In this tutorial, we'll create this Cyber Susan. Subscribe, click the bell, and let's go! First, we'll remove the cube and add our monkey. Rotate it 90 degrees around the Z-axis. Let's go to the camera, press the lock to move with the camera. With the camera selected, go to its settings and set the focal length parameter to 24 mm to get a more epic look. Now select our Susan, unlock the lock and go to the modifiers section. Let's add a subdivision surface modifier to make the topology smoother. We'll also add a remesh modifier to change the topology. Set the voxel size to 0.04. Next, in order to transform the topology into hexagonal plates, move on to the geometry nodes. Click New and add a triangulate node and a dual mesh node. And we got the topology of hexagons. Let's add a split edges node and a separate geometry node. Here we enable the face domain, and for the selection connect to wave texture, color parameter. Let's switch wave type to rings, and select spherical direction. Also select the saw profile. Add a color ramp node and move the black slider. Now we may see our pattern. I'll set the scale value to 0.45. And in order to animate, I'll connect a scene time node, the frame parameter, to the phase offset socket. Now I add a map range node and specify the length of our animation, from frame 1 to frame 2 at 50. And during all this time it must pass the value of tau. In this case, the pattern will be looped. The animation moves slowly, so I'll add a math node in floored medulla mode. I'll add an integer node and connect it to the value in from max inputs. And I'll set the value to 50 frames. During this time, our pattern will go through a complete cycle. The speed suits me. In order to change the pattern placement, we'll connect a position node and a vector math node in add mode. Let's move the pattern so that it goes from the bottom. And in order for it to move in the opposite direction, we add a math node in multiply mode and multiply the output values by -1. So now the pattern will go in the opposite direction. Let's add a join geometry node and connect the remaining geometry. Add a set position node and connect it to the selection. Here we connect a normal node to the offset and insert a vector math node between them. Switch it to the scale mode and enter a value of -0.02 to make the pattern slightly deeper. Let's add an extrude mesh node and enter a value of 0.05 here. Now the pattern protrudes evenly from both sides. To make it more interesting, let's connect the color ramp to the offset scale and add a map range node. Here we set the following values, from 0 to 1 and from 0.025 to 0.08. And thus the wave moves smoothly, gradually rising upward. Let's add materials to our scene. Enable the viewport shading. Open the material tab and add a new material. I'll name it steel. Set the metallic value to 1. I'll pick a dark color with a slightly cool shade. Let's create the second material. You may name it emission. And in the emission section, let's pick red color and set the strength to 10. Let's add a set material node and connect it before the separate geometry node to apply the material to all geometry. Next, add a separate geometry node. Switch to the face domain, as the selection will connect the top faces to separate the side edges from the top ones. Let's add a set material node and connect the inverted output to this node. Now we connect the set material node to the join geometry node. As a material, we'll choose our emission material. And thus the side edges begin to glow. To make the geometry more interesting, let's add a scale elements node. With its help, we can scale the side faces. And in order to add thickness to our plates, let's go to the modifiers and add a solidify modifier. The default values are fine for us. Let's move on to the render settings. Switch to cycles, GPU compute, reduce the number of samples and check the viewport denoise. For volumetric light, go to the light paths, max bounces. And here we should set some value for the volume parameter. In the color management section, select Chronos PBR neutral for richer colors. To make the light better, let's go to the compositor. Check the Use Nodes box and enable the display of compositor effects in the camera. Add a glare node. Let's set the threshold to 2 and the size to 5. And now we have a cool glow. Let's move on to setting up the lighting. Go to the shader editor, world type. Delete the background node and add a volume scatter node. Connect it to the volume input and set the density to 0.04. Now select our light and go to its settings. Switch the type to area. Select the disk shape. Set the spread to 40 degrees to get a more concentrated light stream. And we'll reduce the power to 150 watts. Let's also give the light a slightly cool tint. In order to fix this artifact, select our Susan first. Now go to the modifiers and add a weighted normal modifier. And in its settings, check the Keep Sharp box. To add a couple more details, let's go back to the Geometry Node Editor. Select our main tree of nodes. Let's add a scale elements node to the main geometry. Set the parameter to 0.95 to make the plate separate. And to make the light not shine through, select these three nodes and duplicate them. Connect the entire geometry to the set position node. Now connect the set position node to the join geometry. Let's adjust the scale parameter. And we duplicate the nodes again. Connect them. And here we set the scale to 2 to get objects like these around. Add a delete geometry node. Switch the domain to face. And for the selection, we'll connect a random value node. Here we can control the number of objects using the probability. I'll also check the render region box. And in the camera settings, turn on depth of field option. I'll choose Susan as the focus object to get the blur around. And by controlling the f-stop parameter, we may change the strength of the blur. I also added camera animation. And here is the result we've gotten. Leave a comment what you think about it. Subscribe so you don't lose it. And see you again in new tutorials.